Before I take you on a romp through the wider world of sitcom Friends, let's talk about my show, Men Behaving Badly.
I was lucky enough to spend the 90s hanging out with my best mate, Martin Clunes. Now, we drank a bit, we laughed loads, and our laddish antics happened to be caught on camera in our sitcom, Men Behaving Badly. Now, our characters weren't actually that bad, just a little bit messy. But what do you expect when you put two devilishly handsome chaps together in a tiny flat?
So how many people have you seen?
Three social inadequates, three psychopaths, a man with a big dog and my mother.
The show first appeared on our screens in 1992, and after a bumpy start, hit its stride with audience figures peaking at 17 million during its six-year run.
Martin and I were pals, and so he actually put me up for the part.
We did the episode of Gary looking for someone to move in, and Tony sort of turns up.
Is this the flat with the room to let?
They've got the same sense of humour, and you just know that it's going to work.
You should have come last week.
Yeah, I lost a bit of paper with the address on it.
Oh, well, come on.
I don't know what happened, you know.
I thought I must have slipped down into the lining of my jacket because I could sort of feel a bit of paper in there, you know. Hi.
Hi.
I tried to work it out through my lining out of an armhole, and that didn't work, so I ended up undoing a lot of the seams with a pair of blunt scissors, which took, ages, and, well, there it was.
What?
An old bus ticket.
At the very end of it, Gary, Gary's character, he turns around and says, you can come and move in. What's in the bag?
Oh, it's a mate of mine who owns a butcher's, and he had this pig's head left over.
And immediately he knows he's got a pal. It's like meeting your soulmate. All of a sudden, you know, farts become neutral. It's okay to fart.
Jeff and two of us, we can make it if we try. Just the two of us.
I think it was the sort of the childish nature of them, you know. It was the joie de vivre, because they didn't seem to care when things were going wrong.
Maybe we should buy some sort of lighter fluid.
Their heads were somewhere, you know, in a completely different place from normal people.
Yeah, and what Tony's doing now is going round and nicely ensuring that the barbecue stays under control.
The secret of a good friendship is to be the same yet different. Gary and Tony were exactly that.
I've never seen a point in crosswords.
Well, you have to fill in all the little squares.
Yeah, Gary's got a job. He's got the flat. He wears a suit to work. Tony, on the other hand, doesn't really have a job. No real responsibilities. Doesn't want any responsibilities. And for that reason, I think they got on very well.
Men Behaving Badly was filmed in front of a live studio audience. But even when the cameras weren't rolling, the bad behaviour continued.
And they're always doing things like that. The studio etiquette just went out the window.
OK, stand by.
Yes, I'm very happy. Got a bit of a stiffy, actually, I'm so happy. Be all right, we'll be all right.
Sometimes it was hard to tell the difference between the show and the just the actors normally just being abusive to each other in a loving way. So it does come through on the outtakes.
It was like a constant game of one-upmanship between all four of us. And Martin, he was brilliant at it.
Hey, mate, did you find out if Dorothy... No, that for a load of old buttons.
For mates to thrive, it doesn't hurt to share a beverage. And Gary and Tony never missed a chance, drinking together in 32 of 36 episodes.
Well, sometimes when you're going out with someone, it's necessary to show them who's the boss. Mm-hmm. And in my case...
Dorothy is.
When Gary and Tony got drunk, they were just up for a laugh. And I think that's what the public loved about it.
We English are terribly inhibited.
Which is why, apparently, we drink more than any other nation, apart from Finland.
Ah. Hence the expression, have you finished that?
But when my character Tony was drunk, morals went out the window. And that really tested the strength of his and Gary's friendship.
I mean, there's an episode where I sleep with his girlfriend, you know, whilst drugged and drunk.
Dorothy, did you remember last night?
I don't want to talk about it. It didn't happen.
Oh, Gary's my best mate.
Well, maybe you should have thought about that last night when you were whispering sweet nothings to me. Like, blimey, this is a turn up for the book.
The stuff that they could do to each other without it ruining the relationship, like, I could sleep with his girlfriend, and within that half an hour, we were at the end of the programme, we were friends again.
So does Dorothy always do that little thing where she...
Tony, no!
That Gary and Tony, neither big nor clever. Join us after the break when we go back to school for some more comedy camaraderie.
The love affair was on the rocks. It was time to split up. But breaking up is always hard to do.
Do you know, smoking that cigarette will take 2 minutes off your life.
Well, what can you do in 2 minutes? Especially at that age.
That would be the Martin Clunes thing. Gary Strang, who's, you know, really rubbish selling security equipment, and the stresses and strains of his daily wranglings within himself, you know, and that was why he would smoke.
I can give up anything you like.
All right, give up smoking then.
Yeah, you name it. Spitting, swearing.
Smoking.
I can give it up. Carrots, masturbation.
Smoking?
Yeah, smoking. All right, there you go.
I don't know what it was about his character. I think it was more to do with Martin than the character. It was more to do with being the naughtiness in Martin.
Hello, I'm your cleaning woman. I've got a separating leg, so I can't clean anything below a waist height. I don't think much of these biscuits. Have you got anything hand-baked by the LaRue room? I've had all my insides taken out, so I'm completely hollow.
Hello, cleaner. I am from the agency.
Gary, come in. Sorry, it's a bit of a mess.
I am here for cleaning.
Oh, there's plenty of time for that.
You're going to staring at me through all the day.
No.
Do you have a squeaky mop, yeast cream, jello duster?
I'm getting a little hint of an accent.
I have come from Portugal to study English.
Oh, Portugal, what a marvellous country. Famous for its port and, of course, its dugal.
You are silly.
Oh. What's your name?
Elena da Silva.
Elena da Silva. Or Elena the Cleaner, as you are now. Just being foolish.
And you are Caddy.
Gary.
Caddy.
Gary.
Caddy.
That's it, exactly.
I am working to pay my English lessons.
I'll pay for them.
You are silly.
Yes.